Hey everybody, I'm here today to tell you when to start studying for your driving theory test. This is actually a question that I get asked really, really often. So many people ask me this question, when should I start studying in order to give myself the best chance at passing? And the best answer would be as early as possible, but that's not always possible because I don't see many like 11-year-olds paying attention to the driving theory in practice for when they take their test in 5 years or 8 years or whatever from then. So I'm going to give you a practical answer. I'm going to give you a real answer. The truth of the matter is that if you want to have a great chance at passing your driving theory test and getting like your learner's permit in order to actually learn to drive, you should actually start studying 2 weeks in advance. And that is the intense, purposeful studying that you should be doing. So you should like actually be studying for the driving theory test, whatever it is called where you live, because they have different names, but they're all basically the tests to actually start learning how to drive. It's like your learner's permit, essentially. Here in Ontario, we call it the G1 license, but they're very similar realities, but they just have different names in different places. 2 weeks in advance, you should start studying for that test. And I mean studying for it as if you would study for a math test. Get the driver's handbook for wherever you live and start studying the driving theory. Watch videos about driving theory and driving skills and study those videos like you're doing right now as you're watching this video. Look online at online free resources and use those to start studying. And you want to do that 2 weeks in advance. And I mean that you really want to do it, I would say, for at least an hour to 2 hours per night for the full 14 days of the 2 weeks, not 5 days a week, like not only weekdays, for the full 14 days. You should try and get roughly, I would say, 20 to 30 hours of intense, purposeful studying time in before you take that test. But in addition, 2 to 3 months before you plan on taking the test, you should start paying attention to what's happening on the road. Now, I know when I was a kid, Before I got my G1 to learn how to drive, I wasn't really paying that much attention to what was happening on the road, to the road rules. I mean, I knew what a stop sign was and I knew the basics, but I wasn't really paying a lot of attention to what was happening around me. I would recommend 2 to 3 months before you're actually going to take your driving theory test to get your learner's permit or whatever it is where you live, start paying attention to what the cars are doing. And don't pay attention to what the cars are doing in the sense the ones that are breaking the rules, but you want to pay attention to cars that are following the rules. What is that car doing before it changes lanes? Can you see, pay attention to your parents that are driving, your siblings that are driving, pay attention to the local transport, like the bus drivers. What are they doing before they change lanes? What are they doing before they do a U-turn? How are they turning the wheel when they park the car? What are they doing when they approach this sign? What do they do when they see that sign? You want to really start paying attention, because all of those things that drivers are doing are the things that you're going to have to know for that driving theory test. So 2 to 3 months before you take the test, start paying attention. It will greatly help you when you actually take that driving theory test, and hopefully you pass. There's no guarantee, but hopefully you pass if you're ready and you get your learner's permit and you can learn how to drive a vehicle. And that's basically it. That is when to start studying for your driving theory test. If you like the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great car and driving videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.